tingling in my fingertips. My right arm wouldn't swing when I was walking. I couldn't do up my buttons on my shirts. I couldn't shave properly. And that prompted me to think that I'd done some nerve damage along the way, which was causing some of these issues. When I was in Parliament and presenting on a bill, and I had a notes in my right hand and it was shaking, and my colleague next to me said, why is your right hand shaking? I said, I'm not sure. So I went to see the neurologist and I asked my wife to come along with me because I was a bit worried about the ramifications of having an operation on my neck because of this issue that I've got. I was diagnosed at that point with Parkinson's, which took us back, both of us. I wasn't expecting it. I didn't know quite much about it. And of course, did a lot of research on it with medication. You can help with some of the symptoms, but there's no cure. As the neurologist basically said, it's like covering a pimple with makeup. You're covering it up, but it's like it's still there. I've been involved with Parkinson's Victoria and have become the ambassador, and hoping to shine a bit of light onto this neurological disease that is the second most common neurological disease to dementia. So there's 27,000 Victorians that have Parkinson's, that live with Parkinson's every day. There are 80,000 in the nation. And according to some neurologists now, that through COVID, that might increase throughout the world. People should actually seek help. And if you don't know what's wrong with you, you can't do anything about it. And once you put a finger on it, like I did, then a whole lot of things change, both physically and mentally. It's a relief. And of course, knowing what it is and dealing with it and having the right medications for it and getting professional help helps. So you're not alone. So as a parliament, you've got to lead the way. You've got to lead the way in the sense that you are an example of how we should be treating the wider community. And when people have concerns, where do they go? They go to their MPs. And what we want to do is lead by example. And that's why it's so important to have a disability plan for Parliament so we can lead the way by example. A sign of a civilised society is that no one's left behind. And of course, just because you know, you might have a disability doesn't mean that you shouldn't have access to all of those things that people without a disability have access to. And so I think a fair and just society is one that looks after everybody, regardless of their ability.